in order to properly understand how to best protect faculty and students from transmission to the virus, it was pretty clear that masks worked. And from there, the question was, okay, so we're going with a face mask. Well, which one? And so then we started looking at a variety of things. And this is actually studies that had also been done previously. And it really comes down to the fate of droplets. In fact, the amount that people spew and the size that they spew, and spew is probably a good word, varies pretty wildly. This is what happens if you just say the word pop with no face covering.
Pop, 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 pop.
And this is what happens if you say the same word, pop, repeatedly with the Notre Dame two-layer face covering.
Pop, 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 pop.
This is what happens if you say the word pop with a typical gaiter where the gaiter is dry.
Pop, 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 pop.
And here's what happens if you do exactly the same experiment, but the gaiter has gotten wet.
Pop, 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 pop.
And as you can see, the word pop has sufficient pressure to literally cause an explosion of droplets from the mass. And that's going to carry with it all the viral particles that have been trapped previously on the material. We have to assume that everyone we interact with on campus is a potential cloud of infectious droplets. And the only way for us to protect ourselves, for our community, our university, is to wear a mask to go and control the emission of the droplets. A two-layer mask or other commercial mask or homemade mask will be much more effective.